Okay, Cassandra on acid. Why? What does that mean exactly? Cassandra on acid is meant to express the result of an integration that we've done with our XAP product with Cassandra. And it's eye-catching. It's kind of funny. I think the alternative was too ghastly, which is probably more accurate, that it's acid on Cassandra. But so anyway, the synergy, this is one of the emergent properties of combining these two clusters, and there's others that I'll get to. Let's move on. They're both clustering technologies. They're complementary. Cassandra is big data storage, as everybody knows, disk-based. GigaSpace's XAP is an in-memory product, in-memory processing, transactional, ACID transactional, runs logic in-memory with in-memory access to data. So we have extremely low latencies on reads and writes and processing. And when you blend these two together, they're both horizontally scalable. They're both self-healing. When you put the two together, you wind up with a schema-free data model, ultra-low latency, ACID transactions, strong consistency, and real-time event processing. And actually, the idea is pretty simple. But just to give an analogy, take for example the integration of Storm with Cassandra to store state. If everybody's not aware, Storm is a stream processing system that uses Cassandra for persistence, or can use Cassandra for persistence. Parallel processing, it needs strong consistency. It implements continuous query, distributed RPC. And each of these clusters plays to its own strengths. And in general, most of these properties are present in GigaSpaces as well, although GigaSpaces is a more general purpose product, not focused on stream processing in particular. So if we just go really quick over GigaSpaces, what I really should have put here is Zap. We have a couple products, but XAP is what I'm talking about. It's an in-memory cluster federation. It's ACID transactional, as I said before. It's not eventually consistent. It's strong consistency, highly available, and horizontally scalable. So partition memory and allows you to store data as objects as well as documents. And memory is viewed as the primary storage mechanism. So the idea is extremely simple. We marry these two. One of the features of Zap is that it can do right behind synchronization with changes in the in-memory cache. And users effectively can, by accessing Cassandra through Zap, are able to have what is effectively a transactional veneer on top of Cassandra. Zap communicates with Cassandra behind the scenes in an LRU mode, an LRU cache eviction mode. And so various features that you would only find in a relational database suddenly become possible. So some key differences: Zap is actually an application platform, so it stores web tier all the way through to data. Cassandra's Zap is transactional. Cassandra's not. They're both distributed, and they're both elastically scalable. They're natural complements, and one of the nice things is that the combination of these two can provide a bridge towards applications that can't tolerate any level of consistency simply by accessing Cassandra through Zap. It's a simple integration, really. Zap is an external data source plugin that we have. It's LRU. Queries on the data grid actually pass through and are translated into SQL queries and delivered back through the grid to the users. Let me zip through. I'm taking too long. So I think as a takeaway here, just to finish, Zap can be thought of as an in-memory object-oriented database, really, with stored procedures, essentially, and event processing. And by fronting Cassandra with Zap, you get ACID transactions, even XA transactions with external data sources. So that's it. That's about out of time.